Dear graduates, on behalf of the trustees of the Toronto District School Board, I offer my congratulations on your accomplishments. During these unprecedented times of physical distancing and remote learning, none of that diminishes what you have accomplished in your efforts. I join your parents, your teachers, your administrators, and your friends and caregivers to tell you how proud we are of you and of your accomplishments. And I wish you all the best as you continue your education. Again, we're not sure what September will look like, but we are sure, 100% sure you will succeed. You will change the world. We're counting on it. Stay well, stay kind, and have a wonderful summer.
Good afternoon to all graduates, teachers, and parents. Let me introduce myself. My name is John Chasty, and I have the pleasure of serving your school and other schools in our learning network. I will start by saying that I was hoping to see you in your gym, all dressed up and smiling. A virtual speech is different, however, times are different. The last 3 months have been challenging for you, your families, and your teachers. You have learned to be even stronger, more resilient, and creative with your learning. With my few words today, I would like to congratulate you on your graduation and to wish you great success next year and the years after at your new school. You will of course encounter challenges in September, new classes, new friends potentially, new teachers, and a new way of learning in a hybrid world. Remember that you are all global learners. Make use of collaboration, enhance your communication and critical thinking skills to innovate and make your mark on the world. You represent our current and future leaders, and I know that going forward, you will focus on social justice and doing what is right. Félicitations et passez un bon été. Merci, thank you.
We would first like to thank Trustee Shelley Laskin and Superintendent John Chasty for supporting our graduates. We would like to thank the many dedicated staff who have played a role in the lives of our graduates throughout their time at Forest Hill. Graduates, whether you have been at Forest Hill for 1 year, 2 years, or 10 years, know that our teaching staff and support staff have supported you, believed in you, and worked tirelessly to help you achieve success. Graduates, we know that this is not the graduation we all envisioned months ago, but we want you to stop for a moment. Look to your left and to your right. Give your family a smile and a wave. Think of all the teachers who have supported your learning journey. Be proud of your accomplishments. Enjoy this moment.
What a journey it has been from the moment you first walked into Forest Hill to now. Today, we would like to leave you with three important thoughts to consider. The first is to understand the strengths you possess and the difference you can make in this world. This is a critical time in your educational careers. We encourage each of you to find the subjects, interests, and eventual career paths that make you happy. Be mindful of those around you and always respond to injustice, be it anti-racism, anti-Black racism, anti-oppression, environmental concerns, and homophobia. As graduates of Forest Hill, some of you will be exploring different opportunities at various schools next year. We encourage each of you to inspire a new friend, a new classmate, to adopt the golden rule, to consider their support for a cause and to stand up to injustice in the same way that all of you know how to do. This is the power of one person. If each of you inspires one person, even two, three, imagine the difference you can make in our community and even beyond. You have power. We hope that you find that power in yourself so that you can work to build a better world. A world that is inclusive and anti-oppressive. You deserve the best, and once you work hard and collaborate with those who love and care for you, I have no doubt that you will achieve the best.
Appreciate your family. When we think of Forest Hill Junior and Senior Public School, we think of family. Take a moment to think of everyone who has supported you, encouraged you, comforted you, congratulated you. These are the same people who will continue to be there throughout your learning journey. There is an obvious sense of family in our school community, individuals looking out for one another, and a genuine sense of friendship and support. This is a very special group of graduates who will be moving on, but you can always refer to one another as Forest Hill family, no matter what independent path you may pursue.
Finally, enjoy life's moments. It's always nice to capture a moment with a selfie or a post on social media, but what about the moment? What about the sights, the smells, the tastes, the sounds? How do these special moments feel? What are you learning? Today is one of those days. There will be some laughs, a few tears, some virtual hugs, and maybe some high-five emojis. Remember each of these moments, because this is a culmination of a special time at Forest Hill, and you are connected to some special people who helped to create some very significant memories. Graduates, please remember to find opportunities in life that make you happy and inspire you to make a difference. Always show appreciation to your family and enjoy life's moments in your minds and in your hearts.
Remember, you are the best version of you. Always stay true to who you are and the things you stand for. Believe in yourself and trust in your ability to persevere and achieve success.
Congratulations, graduates. You have worked hard. You have shown resilience in a most unusual time, and we are confident that you will continue to rise to life's challenges and accomplish great things as you continue on your journey to high school and beyond.
The Principal's Cup is awarded each year to a strong, well-rounded student who demonstrates a consistent commitment to their academic success, as well as involvement in a range of school activities. The student must also exemplify good citizenship through their attitude and their actions. This year's winner has done exceedingly well in her language arts studies and has also demonstrated exceptional perseverance and effort in math that has led her to high academic standing in that subject as well. In addition to her broad academic success, this student also demonstrated leadership beyond the classroom through her involvement in many school clubs, including our Student Leadership Club, Dungeons and Dragons Club, IRGSA, and Drama Club. She and a close friend also worked to raise awareness about a specific neurological condition so that students could understand and be accepting of those who are dealing with this issue. Our Principal's Cup winner is a model citizen who is kind and supportive of others and who consistently, respectfully, and vocally advocates for social justice causes for which she feels strongly. It is my honor to present the 2019-2020 Principal's Cup Award to Rachel Farber.
Today is a formative day for all our Forest Hill Public School graduating class. The past 2 years have seen great challenges and unprecedented change. We have had to be flexible and compassionate in ways never imagined before. Education is not only to fill curious minds with how things work, but also to encourage that curiosity forward into the future as lifelong learners. the students at Forest Hill Public School arrived to find a music program that many did not expect. Soon, they were figuring out, through trial and error, the chord of G major, the notes on the first strings, or which fingers were numbered which way. Some struggled greatly with these concepts, while others grasped them immediately. Many will continue their education and adult lives remembering playing this musical instrument. We have had some great experiences over the past 2 years. None of you, hopefully, will ever forget how to play G major. Maybe you will walk down the street in your 30s, singing Yakety Yak at the top of your lungs. Every Remembrance Day, you'll probably think about recruiting sergeants or O Canada in music class. Some may also remember our art class project, Is Freedom Free? Or What Is Freedom? Personally, I will never forget the 30 or so of you that built the log bridge at Camp Muskoka. Thank you for having 2 great years and artistic years at Forest Hill. I wish you all many more years of lifelong learning. Thank you.
It's our honor to present the Larry Grossman Award to an outstanding student from this remarkable cohort. This student has demonstrated excellence in both academic and social spheres while maintaining their charisma, kindness, and positive outlook. This student was always ready to lend a helping hand and provide some insightful contribution to live and classroom discussion. We are pleased to grant this award to Yanni Mikrogiannakis. Congratulations, Yanni.
Hello graduates, Mr. Cates here. I wanted to send you my very best wishes for reaching this important milestone. You all worked very hard this year and are deserving of many accolades. This has certainly been a most unusual year, but you managed with perseverance, resilience, flexibility, and above all, humor. Probably the most important take-home message is to be kind to yourself and to each other. Martin Luther King Jr. once said, "Intelligence plus character, that is the goal of a true education. Believe in yourselves, stand up for what's right, and always treat others the way you want to be treated. Congratulations to the Forest Hill graduating class, and best wishes for the future."
We all have the ability to lead by example and help those around us. The Principal's Award for Student Leadership is presented each year to one student who demonstrates initiative and leadership. This year, the OPC Award for Principal Leadership is presented to a student who took initiative on several occasions to support enhanced learning at Forest Hill. This student feels strongly about eliminating racism and intolerance and is willing to put these feelings into action. Early in the year, he had proposed a plan to engage our community in Holocaust education and even followed through with this plan and worked collaboratively with the admin team in a remote setting with a virtual Yom HaShoah presentation for our community. It is our pleasure to present the OPC Award for Student Leadership to William Wall.
Hello, Grade 8s. What a milestone this is. Congratulations on graduating Grade 8 and moving on to Grade 9. What a successful year it was for all of you, and what a fantastic year. I hope you made an awesome friendships that will last a lifetime. And also, I want to wish you all the best on your way to Grade 9. May your journey be a fun one. May you grow and flourish and become the very best selves as this world belongs to all of you. Thank you, and again, all the best.
Class of 2020, diplômé de 2020. A message in English will follow. Félicitations, classe de 2020. Vous avez été courageux, vous avez travaillé fort, vous avez fait preuve de gentillesse, de patience, de persévérance, et vous avez eu une année très intéressante avec beaucoup de choses imprévues, mais vous avez survécu, vous avez appris, vous avez continué. Et c'est ça qui est important. Il faut continuer, il faut toujours continuer à apprendre. Alors, bonne continuation, un avenir plein de succès et de bonheur. Félicitations. Class of 2020, you have been brave. You have survived a year full of unforeseen circumstances, and nevertheless you have persevered, you have continued, and that is what is important, is to never stop learning. I wish you a bright, successful future full of happiness, and again, never stop learning. Merci. Graduating class of 2020, diplômé de 2020. I'm here today to present a very special award, and that is the William Saunderson Award, which is given traditionally at Forest Hill to a student who has shown outstanding effort. When I heard this description, I immediately thought of one of my students, someone very special, someone who has overcome a lot of challenges and who has met each of those challenges with determination and kindness and resilience, and someone who has inspired her classmates, her friends, and the entire school community. And this recipient of the William Saunderson Award is Maddie Lee. Félicitations, congratulations, Maddie, for all of your efforts and hard work at Forest Hill. In September of 2018, you came back to school after a year of difficulty, of health challenges. And when you came back to Forest Hill, you could have chosen the easy way out. You could have said, well, I'm not going to go back to the French extended program. That's a lot of work. And it is. It's a lot of extra work in the best of times. And instead of doing that, you came back to extended French and you worked very hard. And I remember in that September when we had a heat wave and our class was working down in the basement lunchroom because it was too hot to stay in our classroom. And it was the first week of school and I had forgotten my pen upstairs in the classroom. And I said, oh, est-ce que quelqu'un a un stylo? And within 3 seconds, without saying a word, you handed me a pen. And in that moment, I knew, I said to myself, Maddie's gonna be okay in our French program. And you were more than okay. You faced challenges, like I said, with determination and grace. And you showed kindness, you showed leadership in every single day, every single opportunity that you had at school. And I want to congratulate you on behalf of all of your teachers at Forest Hill, on behalf of the community at Forest Hill, for your perseverance, your fierce spirit of survival, of thriving, and everything you've done to inspire us all. Merci, Maddie. Bonne continuation et félicitations.
This year's Female Athlete of the Year goes to Carly Nicholson. We're so proud of Carly, and this year I've had the pleasure of being her phys ed teacher, and Carly has been an outstanding athlete. Not only is she an outstanding athlete, but she's an incredible leader in her class, always helping set up games and activities, making sure everybody is included, and always helping everyone be their best. It's been a pleasure coaching Carly and teaching her this year.
Congratulations, Carly, on being Female Athlete of the Year. It is extremely well deserved. I've had the pleasure of coaching you from grade 4 to grade 8, and I can honestly say that I've seen you grow not only in your talent and ability, but also as a leader. You were always the one student or athlete who we always turned to help and secure the win in any game. You helped lead your teammates, you led by example, and I'm just so proud to say that I've coached you over the past few years at Forest Hill. Congratulations, Carly.
Congrats, Carly. Likewise, it's been a real pleasure having you come to Forest Hill in grade 4, and it's exciting to see your progress over the last 5 years as you've grown as a person, an athlete, so congratulations. I'd also like to announce the Male Athlete of the Year this year, who is Aiden Nicholson. Aiden is an exceptional athlete. He's a leader. He's a skilled athlete in many sports. He came to the Forest Hill in grade four as well and has shown tremendous progress and growth over the last 5 years. Aiden, it's been a pleasure to coach you, to chat with you on the sidelines, and to talk all things sports. So congratulations. You two are tremendous athletes, and you've cemented yourselves as some of the GOATs, the greatest of all time at Forest Hill Public School.
Congratulations, Aiden. It's very well deserved. I have really enjoyed coaching you basketball, you along with Carly. It is very well deserved, and just getting to know your family, and I know Liam will do well following in your footsteps. Congratulations.
Congratulations, Aiden, and congratulations, Carly. We could not think of two more deserving students.
Recording. Just a message to the grade 8 graduates this year, the class of 2020. We wish you guys all of the best, all of the grade 8s. We will miss you so much. We hope you have great summers and a great time in high school. Specifically for me, to class 8A and 8B, I just want to say thank you for such a great year. It was so wonderful to get to be your core teacher this year, and I wish you guys all the best.
Congratulations, grade 8s. We're so proud of you and everything that you've accomplished this year. It was such an honor to be one of your teachers and get to know so many of you this year. To 8C, thank you so much for all the memories and all the fun that we had in class. I looked forward to coming every single day and being your teacher. I know that you guys are going to do some amazing things, and congratulations.
Congratulations, class 2020, we did it. You're going to be moving on to bigger and better things. Can't wait to hear about all the new adventures you have in high school. 8D, congratulations. I look forward to hearing about your progress and what you're getting up to in high school. Thanks again for a great year. Happy graduation.
It started as an initiative at Forest Hill Public School to try to make Remembrance Day ceremony more relevant and personal to the grade 7 and 8 students. We included the inquiry question, "Is freedom free?" in art class, and many played their instruments during the ceremony. This year, we also asked you, the students and parents of Forest Hill, to send and share family history, photos, memorabilia, with the names and dates included as a legacy project. I asked the admin which student would be best to take on such a task, and Adine Narbave was chosen. She did an amazing job organizing and transferring the pictures into a unique visual that will be added to over the years to come. She arrived every day a half an hour early to school to administer the program and was even reworking and adding to the slideshow at 11 p.m. the night before. It was because of Adi's commitment, dedication, and perseverance that the Legacy Project was such a great success. She was a great communicator and was a great asset to the ceremony. It is my honor to give the Georgia Economides Award to Adi Narbave.
Hello, Grade 8s. It's been one crazy year, to say the least. So I want to congratulate you for making it through. It will be a special year for you to remember, I'm sure, always. I wish you all the best as you enter high school. Hope you take on all the challenges you face and enjoy all the special moments. And I wish you great success in all your future endeavors. Congratulations, class of 2020. You earned it, you deserve it, and good luck to everyone. Mr. Samsaris.
Hello there, graduates. I'm so proud of you right now, and I'm very excited that you're going to start a whole new chapter in your lives. I wish you all the best in high school and in your bright future that lies ahead. I hope you follow your dreams, and congratulations on your graduation. This is a really special day.
Grossman was a Canadian politician and businessman. During his time in politics, he introduced the Ontario Tax Credit Program to assist the elderly and low-income families. It is in the spirit of helping others that our student leadership program operates.
The student we have selected to receive the Alan Grossman Award was an integral member of the Student Leadership Club. We could always count on her to ensure that our initiatives were a success. We are very proud to present this award to Carolina Tessman.
Peter Patterson, whom this ESL award is named after, is a former vice principal of Forest Hill Public School who retired in 1990. He was a gentle soul who passionately supported ESL students. He knew students should be supported based on their needs so they would be successful. We, the ESL team, have decided to give the award to two students this year, Hua Xu and Alon Ofer Lamden.
Hua Xu has demonstrated a true passion to learn English. Hua, you came to Forest Hill in January after moving to Toronto from Beijing and displayed great resilience and perseverance in your efforts to learn a new language. You did this all while becoming familiar with a completely new school environment. You always come to ESL class ready to learn and eager to improve your skills. You have such a positive attitude that we really admire, stepping outside of your comfort zone to involve yourself in your different classes. We are very proud of you and your progress, and we know that your enthusiasm for learning will continue to help you in your future endeavors.
Alon, you have shown a lot of growth in your language development since starting at Forest Hill 2 years ago when you first came from Israel. Alon's success can be attributed to his willingness to ask and then receive help. He was a very positive presence in the ESL program and often encouraged others to stay on task. Alon, you have only just started to tap into your potential, which is quite vast. All the best as you return home. We all hope that our paths cross again.
It is an honor to present you, Hua and Alon, with the Peter Patterson Award.
Hi, Grade 8s. So, this is it. You're finally graduating. Congratulations. Many of you I have had the privilege of teaching for 2 years, and it's been awesome being able to watch you grow and develop and work and learn. So I just wanted to say congratulations, and I wish you all the best in the future. Remember to be kind to one another. Think about how your words and actions impact each other. And I wish you all the best for grade 9, and come back and visit whenever you want. We're all here for you. Congratulations. Woohoo, you did it.
Dear graduating class of 2020, it was such an honor to meet you and to teach you and to spend this year with you. I want to wish you nothing but joy and happiness and success in life and the courage to pursue your own dreams and to always have determination in what you do and perseverance and resilience. And don't forget that there are close to 8 billion people on the planet, and no one is like you. You are truly unique with your own gifts, your own talents, your own dreams. Make sure that you always have the courage to follow your heart and to pursue those dreams. Be bold and have a lifetime of success, joy, health, and happiness. Congratulations.
Hi there. This year we are very honored to present this award to a very special young lady. She has shown a great deal of perseverance and determination. She has always worked with a very strong sense of pride. She's kind, empathetic, and with an enormous amount of artistic talent. We are very happy and very honored to present this year's Gary Patrician Award to Gwen Lawrence. Congratulations, Gwen.
Hi, grade eights.
Congrats. It's graduation. Wish you all the best luck. Grade nine. Been a good year. We had a lot of fun. And stay safe. Have a great summer.
Hello teachers, students, staff, and families of Forest Hill. I am John Huang, and it is my great honor to be one of the valedictorians for our graduation. When I first walked into this school, the first thing I remarked was its size. It was a lot larger than my old school and other schools that I have seen before. Although it's such a large school, it's filled to the rim with capable teachers, caring staff, and kind students. So, I would like to thank all Forest Hill staff, such as Mr. Birnbaum, Mr. Sonnenberg, and Ms. Stewart, office admin and caretakers, for their hard work in cleaning and running our school and turning it into a safe environment. Our teachers for their dedication in educating us and always being there for us. Our parent council for raising money for our school necessities, our Forest Hill volunteers who make the fun fairs and other events possible, and especially my fellow graduating peers of 2020 for an amazing 4 years at Forest Hill. When I try to visualize Forest Hill, I don't see a school, but a community, a big family even, a family that does everything together, from trips to places like Camp Muskoka and events like the Dance-a-thon. Now that we have all graduated, you might feel a little differently, think a little differently. I'll tell you this, we are different. Different in a good way. Thoughtful, helpful, and most importantly, we are dependable. Although we're not having a grad like we all imagined, today is still our day. Today is still the long-awaited day. We enter the new phase of our lives at high school. I would now like to share a quote with you from a book that is well connected with one of the most devastating events in human history, the Holocaust. This book, or rather diary, was written by a young girl by the name of Anne Frank. How wonderful is it that nobody need wait a single moment before starting to improve the world? So how are we going to start changing the world for the better of future generations to come? That is to leave a legacy. Leaving a legacy isn't about getting money, power, or recognition. It's about leaving those whom we cross paths with, or those who look up to us, with a little more happiness and hope. When you remember our time here at Forest Hill, it won't be by grades, popularity, or talent, but our relationships, the kind of person you were. These are our legacies. There is one thing left for me to say, and that's congratulations, graduates. Félicitations, diplômés. It was my absolute pleasure spending my time here at Forest Hill with all of you. Class of 2020, thank you again for this splendid time. And from the bottom of my heart, I wish you all the very, very best. Thank you.
Here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones that did I. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories. And the memories, bring back your.
Hello, fellow students, teachers, families, and staff. I am Sylvia Matthew, a grade 8 student. It is an amazing honor to have been elected valedictorian. To begin with, I have many thanks to give. Thank you to our parents and teachers for sharing their wisdom and supporting us every step of the way. Thank you to our wonderful staff for creating a welcoming, clean environment. Thank you, Forest Hill, for being not only a place of learning, but a second home, a home I looked forward to every day because I was excited to learn, to see my friends and brilliant teachers. Most of all, thank you, fellow graduates, for a terrific, memorable time. When we first arrived at Forest Hill, we were caterpillars, young and vigilant. We were wrapped up in cocoons, forced to adapt to our new environment. And adapt we did. We made friends, joined clubs, and participated in lengthy class discussions. We took part in community events, such as the Pride March, Falcon Fest, and field trips. And we had a blast. I remember hiding in the corner of the gym during the dance-a-thon with its vibrating floor and blinding lights, and the Falcon Fest, where I lost most of my tickets and, with the help of my friends, eventually found them in my backpack. I loved our bus rides home, playing and chatting in the village park, and having class parties. Camp Muskoka and Island School were also splendid. We made memories that will last a lifetime. I don't regret any of my Forest Hill experiences, even the unfortunate ones, as they only strengthened our bonds. Although we studied a variety of subjects, it is really the life lessons learned that will stick with us for years to come. Be honest, work hard, stay determined, be patient, kind, and respectful, and always be yourself. Now, as our last year comes to a close, our cocoons unraveling, we come out as beautiful butterflies, free to take risks and discover passions. We are thrust into high schools, ready for a new beginning, a new adventure, a new chapter. Our friends and teachers did not give us wings, but taught us to fly. We are more prepared than ever to journey far and explore new horizons. A butterfly is far more capable than a caterpillar. At Forest Hill, we were also taught the importance of welcoming change. I will continue to carry this lesson with me and urge you to do the same. Instead of being upset or negative about a situation we often can't control, embrace the change and find the bright side. Every cloud has a silver lining. At Forest Hill, we learned the importance of positivity and hope. Sometimes we fall into holes. The path to success is not easy. It is a bumpy, challenging, frustrating ride. And we fall. Sometimes we fall deep. I, like many, fell into a hole during my time at Forest Hill. These years were extremely formative and therefore difficult. My friends, teachers, and family supported me, lent me a hand, tried to pull me out of this dark hole, even if they didn't realize how much their actions meant to me. But it is important to recognize, ultimately, it's your decision, like it was mine, whether you stay in the hole, safe from the dangers of the world above, embarrassment, rejection, and failure, or climb out, take risks, take chances, and see the sunshine again. I chose the second option. If you ever find yourself in a hole, remember, it's okay to wallow in self-pity for a little while, but you must rise again. Come out, realize what matters the most to you, and chase your passions. Be yourself, and do so unapologetically. For years we grew together, but now it is time to part. On this bittersweet occasion, we must remember to hold on to our memories and friends, but make space for those to come. We must welcome and embrace change. We must stay positive, and we must stay true to ourselves, striving for happiness and fulfillment rather than mere success. Ours is a unique generation, currently in the midst of unprecedented events and historic upheaval. Do not just embrace change, be the catalyst of change and transform the world. Thank you for everything, Class of 2020. Our time at Forest Hill has been unforgettable. Goodbye.
Thank you.
we would like to extend our thanks to the entire grad committee. This dedicated group of staff members put hours of planning and compiling today's graduation. Our sincere appreciation to SAC. Thank you for your ongoing support as we work together to enrich the opportunities for our students. We also want to acknowledge the many parents of graduates who have served as SAC members over the years. Thank you for the hours of work and dedication to Forest Hill students and families over the years.
We have all come together as a Forest Hill family to celebrate the accomplishments of our graduates. Despite the challenges we are currently facing, we confront adversity together and look to the bright future ahead.
Thank you to our Grade 8 graduates for leaving a lasting legacy. And remember to always stand for social justice and strive to treat others the way we know they want to be treated.
Congratulations, grads. Have a safe and enjoyable summer.